Hello everyone, welcome to EduTab. So type in a chat box that you can hear me. Am I audible to you? Good evening everybody. Please type yes if you can see me and hear me properly. Good evening, perfectly imperfect. Good evening, Pratyusha, Sangeeta. Please type yes if you can hear me. Okay, I can see that you can hear me. Okay, so welcome to EduTab guys. This is the lecture third of the live sessions. So we have already covered two lectures in which we discussed GA current affairs, and I'm sorry that it is written here that it is also a GA current affairs, but it is the session of ESI current affairs. And in this particular lecture we will discuss September, October plus November. So we are going to discuss most important MCQs of 3 months, that is September, October and November. And in next session, that is tomorrow, we are going to discuss January as well as December. So, yes. Okay. So, if you want to subscribe to our NABARD courses, so there is 50% discount on it. You have to use the code NABARD50. And if you have any query regarding the course or whatever your preparation, you can call us at 81462-07241. All right, so first we will start with the September ESI current affairs. So let's start with it. So first question is, recently Election Commission of India has launched which of the following programs to verify and authenticate voter details. So there is a program that has been launched by the Election Commission of India. So what is the name of that program? So here are the five options given. You have to tell me the correct answer. As you can see that these options are very close, so you have to exactly, you have to know the name of the program that has been launched by the Election Commission of India. Yes, most of the people are saying option 2. Yes guys, you are correct. Option 2 is the answer here. Electors Verification Program is the name of the program that has been launched by the Election Commission of India. This is a very important thing that can be asked in the exam. So this program has been launched to verify as well as to authenticate the voter details. Next question is, which of the following bodies hosted the 4th General Assembly of Association of World Election Bodies at Bengaluru in India? So recently an Association of World Election Bodies was organized, and it was organized at Bengaluru, India. So which of the following body hosted it? So one information is given in the question itself that it was organized at Bengaluru, but which body hosted this program, this assembly? Okay, most of the people are saying first Election Commission of India. Yes guys, that is correct. It is related to World Election Bodies. So yes, Election Commission of India has hosted this particular program. And you need to remember the venue also. It was hosted at Bengaluru. And one more important fact is that India will take over the Association of World Election Bodies chair. That India is going to be the chair of the World Election Body for the 2019 to 21 term. That's why this question is more important. Yes guys. Next question is, which of the following organizations has announced to fund pro poor tourism development projects of UP government? So which organization, which of the following organization is going to support pro poor tourism development projects of UP government? Yeah, can you tell me the right answer? Yes, perfectly imperfect is saying World Bank. Yes. Most of you are saying World Bank, which is a correct answer. World Bank is the one which has announced to fund this particular development project of UP government. So you need to remember that pro-poor tourism development project is related to UP government. That can also be asked in the exam. Next is, recently which of the following declarations has been adopted at the 14th Conference of Parties, that is COP14, to the UN Convention to Combat Desertification? So which of the following declaration is related to the desertification, to combat desertification? Yes, tell me the answer. And this particular declaration has been adopted at the COP14. Yes, so you have to tell that which declaration is related to combat desertification. Yes, guys. Yeah, most of you are answering it correct. That is New Delhi Declaration is the one which is related to the desertification, and it has been adopted at COP14. Yes. Next is, how much amount India has announced to contribute to the Global Fund for AIDS, TB and Malaria for 6th replenishment cycle in the month of September? So recently India announced some amount for the Global Fund for AIDS, TB and Malaria. So how much is that amount? You need to answer that. Most of you are saying 2, that is $22 million. Yes, that is correct. India has contributed this much of amount to the Global Fund for AIDS, TB and Malaria. This is a very important question. This can be asked in the exam. Yes. Next is, which of the following statements is incorrect in context of the 5th Eastern Economic Forum recently held in the month of September? So this question is very lengthy, so you have to read it very carefully. Incorrect statement is asked in the question, that which of the statement is incorrect in context of 5th Eastern Economic Forum. So we all know that 5th Eastern Economic Forum was held in Russia. It was particularly held at Vladivostok in Russia. I've given you the hint that 4th statement is correct here. Incorrect statement is asked here. Okay, most of the students are saying third option is incorrect here. Yes, guys, you are correct. The third option is incorrect. India was not the only Asian country to participate in this 5th Eastern Economic Forum. And some more things I want to tell you about that, that it was this particular 5th Eastern Economic Forum was held at Vladivostok in Russia. Yes. Next question is, recently which of the following states has announced to waive surcharge on electricity bills of tube wells? So a particular state government has announced that they are going to waive electricity bills of tube wells, obviously to support the farmers. Yes, so that they can irrigate their fields well. That's why they have waived off electricity bill of tube wells. Which of the state government has done it? Is it Haryana or Uttar Pradesh or Gujarat? Tell me, guys. Yes, most of you are saying it is Haryana. That is correct. Haryana state government has waived off electricity bills of tube wells. Surcharge on electricity bills, yes. Next is, recently which of the following organizations has released the Travel and Tourism Competitive Report 2019? So guys, all the reports and indices which are in last 6 months, which are in news, that are very, very important for you. So Travel and Tourism Competitive Report has been released by which organization here? I think most of you will be confused between option A and option 2, as they both are related to travel and tourism. Give me the correct answer here. Most of you are saying it is World Economic Forum. That is correct. Yes, option 4 is correct here. Travel and Tourism Competitive Report has been released by World Economic Forum. And you don't need to be confused by the World Travel and Tourism, which are given in the option A and option 2. Answer is option 4 actually, World Economic Forum. And in this particular report, India is ranked at 34th place this year. So that is very important the news that you can take away from this particular article or report. Next is, which of the following organizations has released the Global Livability Index in the month of September? Again, one more index is here. It is Global Livability Index. So which organization has released this particular index? Yes, tell me. Global Livability Index. Guys, all the indices and reports are important for you. You need to remember the organizations which release these particular reports or indices, as well as the rank of India. These two dimensions are very important that you need to remember whenever you read about any reports or indices. So most of you are saying it is Economist Intelligence Unit. Yes, option 5th is correct answer. Economist Intelligence Unit released the Global Livability Index, in which Vienna is at the top. That is, Vienna is the city in Austria, and New Delhi and Mumbai have been ranked at 118th and 119th out of the 140 cities in this particular index. So you need to remember the rank of New Delhi and Mumbai, as well as the topper country, which is Vienna. Next is, which of the following is not one of the 5 headline criteria for Global Livability Index? So whenever we read about any indices, there are some parameters or criteria on which ranks are given to the countries or cities. So which of the following is not one of the 5 headline criteria for this particular index? Is it healthcare? Is it education? Or is it water availability? What is the correct answer here? Guys, parameters are also very important, because these type of questions are generally asked in the exam, especially when questions are asked from the indices. Correct answer is option 2, that is, water availability is not one of the 5 headline criteria for this particular index. So what are the 5 headline criteria? First is stability, then healthcare, education, infrastructure, and culture and environment. So you need to remember these 5 parameters. Next question is, which of the following institutes has been selected for setting up sophisticated analytical and technical help institute? In short, it is called as SATHI in the month of September. So which of the following institution has been selected for setting up SATHI? One information is given in the question itself, that SATHI stands for Sophisticated Analytical and Technical Help Institute. This can also be asked in the exam. Generally, these type of question are asked, that what does T stands in SATHI or what does S stands in SATHI. So you need to remember this particular abbreviation so that those type of question can be answered. Okay, most of the students are saying IIT Kharagpur here, which is correct. Yes, IIT Kharagpur is going to set up SATHI Institute. Next is, recently CBSE has partnered with which of the following companies to conduct capacity building program for high school teachers to integrate cloud power technology in K-12 teaching. So you need to remember the name of the company which is going to conduct capacity building program with CBSE. Yes guys, this is related to education sector, which is also a part of your ESI syllabus. Generally, Google and Microsoft, these two companies work in the education sector. Yes, 4th is correct answer. Microsoft India is the one which is going to partner with CBSE to conduct capacity building program. Yes, Microsoft is the correct answer here. Next is, recently National Green Tribunal has directed the center to prepare time-bound action plan for protection of which of the following birds? So recently a time-bound action plan has been released for protection of a particular bird. What is that bird? Yes, recently National Green Tribunal directed the center to prepare action plan for this particular bird. Can you tell me the correct answer here? Yes, answer 3, that is Great Indian Bustard, is the one. Next is, recently Asian Development Bank has announced to upgrade rural roads of which of the following states? So generally ADB or AIIB or World Bank. Generally these three institutes give a lot of amount of money to India to upgrade rural roads or to upgrade education sector or to health sector. So these things you need to remember, that ADB has given has announced to upgrade rural roads of which of the following states? Most of you are saying answer 3. Yes, that is correct. Maharashtra is the one to which ADB will provide the money to upgrade the rural roads. Next is, recently Bal Basera project has been launched for the welfare of children of. So Bal Basera project is related to the welfare of children to a particular sector. So what is that particular sector? Is it given to health workers or IT workers or construction workers or teachers? What is that? Bal Basera project. You need to remember the name of the project. This is very important question. Yes, answer 4 is correct here. Construction workers. So Bal Basera project is for the welfare of the children of construction workers. Next is, which of the following projects has been launched by Kerala government to raise standards of Anganwadis in the month of September? So recently a project has been launched by the Kerala government for the Anganwadi workers. So what is the name of that project? It's a very important project, guys. Especially when it comes to rural areas or women related sectors, these type of questions are generally asked, especially in the NABARD exam. So these type of questions become very important for you. Yes, CRDL is the correct answer here. Most of you have answered it correct. Very good, guys, very good. Yes, and CRDL stands for Child Rearing and Development, a Life Cycle Elucidation. So this is the name of the project which has been launched by the Kerala government. Next is, recently which of the following institutions has partnered with backward Deoria district in eastern Uttar Pradesh to develop it as a model district? So Deoria district is in eastern Uttar Pradesh and it is going to be developed as model district. So which of the following institution has partnered with this to develop it as model district? One information is given in the question itself, that Deoria district is the one which is going to be developed as the model district. And the name of the institution is asked here. Answer is option 2, that is IIM Indore. Yes, it has partnered with this district to be developed as model district here. Yes. Next is, recently the government has announced the setup of a national genomic grid to study the genomic data of which of the following? So recently government has announced that a national genomic grid is going to be established to study the genomic data of the patients of which disease? So you have to tell me the name of the disease of which patients, of the data of the patients is going to be studied in this particular grid. Is it cancer or is it AIDS or is it malaria or TB? Tell me. Yes, guys, answer option 1 is correct here. For cancer patients, this grid is going to be set up. Next is, recently which of the following states has announced to set up a time bank which would lend currency to an hour which could be exchanged to learn a new skill without the need for any paper money? So which of the following state will set up time bank? This is very important question. This will be asked in the exam. There is a very high chances of this question be asked in the exam. Which state has announced to set up time bank? Answer is option 4, that is Madhya Pradesh. Yes, Madhya Pradesh is the one which is going to set up a time bank. Next is, according to the latest release Lancet Commission report, India has been ranked at which of the following positions in terms of number of malaria cases in the world? So as we all know that India scores very high, that is a lot of malaria cases are prevalent in India. So at which place India stands in terms of the number of malaria cases according to Lancet Commission report? This is a very important question, as health is the part of your ESI syllabus and this news is related to your health sector. Option 4, that is India stands at 4th rank in terms of the number of malaria cases in the world. Next is recently an international conference, Aangan. So Aangan stands for augmenting nature by green affordable new habitat. This abbreviation is also very important. So an international conference, Aangan, focused on energy efficiency in building sector took place at which of the following place? So where this international conference of Aangan took place? You have to tell me the name of the city where this particular conference has taken place. Correct answer is option 2, that is New Delhi. Yes, perfectly imperfect has answered it correct. New Delhi is the place where this particular conference has taken place. Next is, recently the Ministry of Home Affairs has formed a 3-member committee headed by which of the following person to oversee the bifurcation of Jammu and Kashmir into 2 union territories. So we all know that state of Jammu and Kashmir has been bifurcated in 2 union territories. One is Ladakh and another one is Jammu. So a committee was formed actually to oversee the bifurcation. So under which person this committee was formed? You need to name, tell me the name of the person. This is a very important question actually. It was so much in news. So this can be asked in the exam. Yes, the name of the person is Mr. Sanjay Mitra, under which this particular committee was formed to oversee the bifurcation of Jammu and Kashmir. Next is, recently the 7th RCEP ministerial meeting was concluded at which of the following place? So RCEP ministerial meeting was held at which of the following places? Correct answer is option 2, that is Bangkok, Thailand. This particular RCEP ministerial meeting was held at Bangkok. Next is, which of the following is the theme of Swachhata Hi Seva, which is a massive countrywide awareness and mobilization campaign launched recently. So Swachhata Hi Seva is a awareness and mobilization campaign. So what is the theme of this particular campaign? Guys, the theme is very important, especially when it comes to government schemes or programs or any week. Generally, these kind of questions are asked in the exam. So theme of Swachhata Hi Seva is plastic waste awareness and management. So option 3 is correct here. Next is, recently Indian Institute of Technology Madras, that is IIT Madras, has announced to collaborate with which of the following to nurture and promote innovative green startups across the country. So which of the following body is going to promote innovative green startups? And IIT Madras is going to collaborate with that particular body to promote green startups across the country. Answer is option A, that is Confederation of Indian Industry. So IIT Madras and CII, these two bodies will come together and they will promote innovative green startups across the country. Next is, recently which of the following entities has dragged India to WTO dispute settlement mechanism over imposition of import duties on certain ICT products including mobile phones, alleging breach of global trade norms. So recently this particular country dragged India to the World Trade Organization dispute settlement. So what is the name of that country? Is it USA or is it Taiwan or Brazil or Australia or Germany? This was so much in news, so I hope you guys know it. Yes, correct answer is option 2 here. That is, Taiwan is the country which dragged India to the World Trade Organization's dispute settlement mechanism. Yes. Next is, Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana was launched in which of the following years? Guys, question related to government schemes are very, very important, especially when we see the previous year trend, then government schemes are, yeah, those are very important for the examination point of view. So in which year Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana was launched? As you all know that this particular scheme has been launched by the Narendra Modi government. So obviously it must be launched after the 2014. Yes, correct answer is option 3, that is 2016. In that year Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana was launched, and this particular scheme was launched to provide free cooking gas connections to the poor families so that health of women as well as children can be protected. Next is, under Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana, a cash assistance is given to each beneficiary. So what is the amount of that cash assistance? You need to tell that. Guys, schemes are very, very important. I am repeating it again and again. You need to remember these kind of dimensions of schemes. So a cash assistance of rupees 1600 is given to the people to get a deposit-free new connection under the Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana. Next is, under Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana, a revised target of coverage of how much million poor families has been set up with the aim to safeguard the health of women and children. So how many people are going to take benefit of this particular scheme? This target has been revised, so that's why it is more important for you, because it has been changed recently. So what is the new target here? New target is 80 million poor families are going to take benefit of this particular scheme. So earlier the target was 50 million, now it has changed to 80 million. Yes, most of you are answering it correct. Next is, recently Asian Development Bank and the Government of India, so they have come together and they have signed a $200 million loan agreement to upgrade rural roads to all weather standard in which of the following states? So ADB and Government of India, they are going to upgrade rural roads of which state? I think you guys know it. Guys, all the contribution of ADB, AIIB and World Bank, these three organizations, all the contribution towards Indian government or any state government, you need to remember the amount that they contribute to India. Correct answer is option 3, that is Maharashtra. So ADB is going to provide $200 million loan so that Maharashtra rural roads can be upgraded. Next is, World Suicide Prevention Day is observed on which of the following dates each year? In these kind of questions, you need to remember the date, that particular date, as well as the theme of the day, as theme keeps changing every year. So World Suicide Prevention Day is observed on which of the following day? Suicide prevention is actually related to health, as suicide prevention is related to the mental health. So this is part of your ESI syllabus. So this day is observed on 10th September. Yes, most of you are answering it correct. I'm surprised actually. Actually, remembering days is very difficult, but you guys know it. Very nice, guys. Your preparation is very good, I hope. And this particular day is organized by the International Association for Suicide Prevention. And World Health Organization is the co-sponsor. Next is, the 6th India-China Strategic Economic Dialogue was recently held at which of the following places? 6th India-China Strategic Economic Dialogue. Venue is asked here. Where this particular dialogue was held? So it was held at New Delhi. So generally, when it comes to the dialogue or conferences which happens between international countries, which happens with international countries, those are generally held in New Delhi. This is a trick kind of, but you need to remember. But if you don't remember and you want to mark it, then New Delhi is generally the correct answer. Next is, which of the following states has launched a project to revive the cultivation of Palmyra, which is also its state tree? So Palmyra is the state tree of a state, and this particular state has launched a project to revive the cultivation of Palmyra. So two information you will get from this particular question. Which state has launched project to revive the cultivation of Palmyra, as well as Palmyra state tree of which state? Yes, correct answer is option 3, that is Tamil Nadu. Next is, according to latest sample registration survey, life expectancy at birth in India has risen marginally to how many years from 68.7 during 2012 and 2016. So from 2012 to 16, it was 68.7. Now it has marginally increased to how much years? Guys, you need to focus on the word marginally. Earlier it was 68.7, now it has been increased to 69. This is a very important question. Next is, according to latest sample registration survey, life expectancy at birth in India among males is highest in which of the following state? So state-wise data has also been given by the sample registration survey. So life expectancy at birth among males is highest in which state? Answer is option 3, that is Delhi. In Delhi, the life expectancy at birth among males is the highest. And in case of females, Kerala is the one. So Kerala has the highest life expectancy rate in case of females, and Delhi had the highest life expectancy in case of males. You need to remember this. So guys, these were the September ESI current affairs. Now we'll take break of few seconds. Yes, most of you have answered it correct. It is Delhi. You are correct. Kejriwal state, Delhi. Yes. We start with October current affairs in few seconds. You guys can take a short break of few seconds. I hope these questions are helping you in your preparation. And as you guys are answering these questions correctly, so I'm hoping that your preparation is very good. Sorry, Deepika, we can't take break of 5 minutes, but yes, you can take few seconds to drink water and all. Good evening, Vaibhav. Amit, these current affairs are collected from various sources which are relevant for your exam, like The Hindu, PIB, Life Mint, Business Standard. We follow a lot of sources for you guys. Okay guys, should I start the October current affairs now? Are you guys ready? Mohit, PDF is available on Telegram. You can take it from there. You can also download it. Explanation of questions are also given in the PDF if you want to revise your current affairs. Okay, shall I start the session now for the October current affairs? Okay guys, okay. Yeah, a lot of you are saying yes. Okay. Let's start with question number 1 of October. So recently, which of the following states has launched 5 new schemes marking the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi? So this year we celebrated 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. On that particular day, a state launched 5 new schemes. What is the name of that state? Which state launched 5 new schemes? Answer is option 2, that is Chhattisgarh. So Chhattisgarh launched 5 new schemes, and the name of the schemes are given here: Mukhya Mantri Suposhan Abhiyan, Mukhya Mantri Heart Bazaar Clinic Yojana, Mukhya Mantri Shahariya Slum Swasthya Yojana, Universal PDS Scheme, and Mukhya Mantri Ward Karyalay. These 5 schemes were launched on the 2nd October 2019, on the birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. Next is, which one of the following mobile apps has been launched in October 2019 for customers to register their grievances and to give suggestions on consumer related issues? So a particular app has been launched so that consumer can register their grievances. So what is the name of that particular app? Yes, Haima, we will take sessions on schemes also. Don't worry. Answer is option 1, that is consumer app. Next is, government has recently issued a notification regarding minimum stipend payable to trade apprentices. What is the amount of the stipend? So recently government has announced a minimum stipend, that is stipend below that is not acceptable. At least that much amount of stipend will be given to the trade apprentices. So what is the amount of that stipend? Correct answer is option 2, that is rupees 5000 to rupees 9000. So on the basis of the skill of the workers, minimum stipend is from 5000 to rupees 9000 rupees. Next is, under which of the following schemes a single window online system for licensing of eating houses, lodging houses has been initiated recently? So under which scheme a single window online system for licensing has been initiated? So guys, this is for eating houses and lodging houses. So you can take hint from that. Juhi Telegram link is available in the description box of this video. Correct answer is option 4, that is Digital India. So under Digital India, a single window online system will be given for licensing lodging houses. Next is, which of the following tech giant or company has recently collaborated with National Health Authority to scale up the online presence of Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana? So which company has collaborated with National Health Authority so that Ayushman Bharat online presence can be increased? Yes, answer me guys. Is it Microsoft, which is generally involved in the government initiatives, or is it Google, or is it Infosys? Yeah, correct answer is option 5, that is Google is the one which have collaborated with the National Health Authority so that online present of Ayushman Bharat can be increased. Next is, which of these international organizations has recently released the EV Ready report? So this particular report analyzes the global potential of countries for electric mobility. So as pollution is increasing, most of the countries are focusing on the electric mobility or electric vehicles. So a particular EV Ready report has been released. So which organization has released this particular report? What is the name of the organization? The answer is option 5, that is World Economic Forum has released this particular report. The name of the report is EV Ready report. Next is, recently which of the following oil companies has launched a drive to turn plastic waste into bitumen? So what is the name of that oil company which will turn plastic waste into bitumen? So lot of effort is going to reduce the plastic waste as well as to recycle the plastic waste. So this particular oil company has launched a drive to turn plastic waste into bitumen. What is the name of that oil company? Correct answer is option 2, that is Indian Oil Corporation has launched this particular drive. Next is, which one of the following state government has inaugurated a village and ward secretariat system? So recently a state government has launched village and ward secretariat system. Which state has launched this particular system? Tell me the correct answer here. Which state has done it? Which state has inaugurated this particular system? Yes guys, it's correct. Andhra Pradesh has launched this particular village and ward secretariat system. Next is, in which of the following places WTO has hosted first World Cotton Day on 7th October? So one information is given in the question itself, that World Cotton Day is observed on 7th October and it was the first World Cotton Day, which was observed on 7th October 2019. It was the first, that's why it is very important. And it was hosted by WTO. So two information are actually given in question itself. So at which place this particular day was hosted? Yes, correct answer is option 2, that is Geneva. Next is, India ranks at which place on Global Competitiveness Index 2019? So in 2019, Global Competitiveness Index was released, in which India ranked at which position? India stands at which position? Global Competitiveness Index. So guys, you need to remember, I already told you that rank of India as well as which particular organization released this particular index. These two dimensions are very important. Correct answer is 68th. Yes, Yes, most of you have answered it correct. And World Economic Forum released this particular index. You need to remember that also. And Singapore is the world's most competitive economy. So it is at the first place. Next is, recently Kayakalp Award has been conferred to public health facilities for showing dedication toward the mission of Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. So those people who have shown a particular dedication toward the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, to those people Kayakalp Awards have been given. So which of these government hospital has been awarded with the first prize in cleanliness? So government organization or government hospital or public hospital were awarded for prizes who have worked toward the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. So which hospital is at first prize in cleanliness? Which is the cleanest hospital or according to these awards? So it is AIIMS Delhi. Yes, most of you have answered it correct. Yes, so under the central government hospital category, AIIMS Delhi was in first position, and under B category, it was Shri Vinoba Bhave Civil Hospital in Silvassa. So you need to remember the name of these two organizations or hospitals. Next is, Global Health Security Index has been released. It is the first comprehensive assessment of epidemic and pandemic threats globally. So which of the following are the key indicators of this index? So some information is given in the question itself, that Global Health Security Index is the first comprehensive assessment of epidemic as well as pandemic threats. That can also be asked in the exam. But in this question, key indicator of this index is asked. So it's a very easy question. When it comes to options, you can deduct the answer through options itself. Yes, the correct answer is option 5. That is all of these. All of these are the key indicators of this particular index. So there are the 6 key indicators of this particular index which are given here. Prevention, detection and reporting, rapid response, health system, compliance with international norms and risk environment. Next is, the World Bank has recently released a report named South Asia Economic Focus, Making Decentralization Work. The name of the report is given here. And this particular report has been released by World Bank. So according to this report, which of these nations has become the second fastest growing economy in South Asia after Bhutan? So Bhutan is on first place, which is the second fastest growing economy. Tell me guys, is it India? World Bank has released this particular report. Answer is option 2, that is Bangladesh. So on first position it is Bhutan, second is Bangladesh. Next is, recently the India Ministerial Dialogue was held at 3rd India Energy Forum by CERAWeek. It was organized at which one of the following places? So guys, in event type news, generally venue are asked or theme is asked. So you need to focus more on venue and theme whenever you read any event type news, okay? Answer is option 2, that is New Delhi. This particular dialogue was held at New Delhi. Next is, which of the following government institutional structure has recently launched India Innovative Index? So again, India Innovative Index has been released by which institution? That is asked in the question. Generally, these two things are generally asked. Parameters or who has released this particular index or rank of India. Answer is option 4, that is Niti Aayog has launched India Innovative Index, IIIII. Next is, recently Central Board of Secondary Education and NCERT. So CBSE and NCERT have launched an online aptitude test. So what is the name of that aptitude test? And it will help students to make the right career choices. So after 10th, students don't have any idea that they should go in science stream or commerce or arts. So this test will help students to make the right career choices. What is the name of this test? And it has been launched by CBSE and NCERT to help the students. The correct answer is option 3, that is Tamanna. The name of the test is Tamanna. Yes. And Tamanna stands for Try and Measure Aptitude and Natural Abilities. So students can measure their aptitude as well as natural abilities, and on that basis they can choose their further career options. Next is, which one of the following nations has recently approved a new tax on giant tech as a part of its 2020 draft budget? So on which company a new tax has been imposed by which of the following nations? It was very much in news actually. And it was part of the 2020 draft budget of that country. Let me give you the hint. It's not India. Now answer me correctly. Most of you are saying it is Italy, and that is the correct answer. Yes. So Italy has recently approved a new tax on the digital companies as part of its 2020 draft budget. Next is, which one of the following state governments has recently signed a loan agreement with the World Bank worth $165 million to support smallholder farmers? So ADB has contributed to rural roads in Maharashtra. Now World Bank has given $165 million to support smallholder farmers. So with which state this loan agreement has been signed? Yes, Dipanshu, it is Rahul Gandhi ka Naniyal. Italy is. Correct answer is option 4th, Odisha. So with Odisha, World Bank has signed loan agreement of $165 million to support smallholder farmers. Next is, recently the board of directors of the New Development Bank has approved two projects, namely Fundo Clima Brazil National Climate Fund project and Renewable Energy Sector Development project. Yes, so what are the worth of these projects? What are the amount of these projects? Two projects has been launched by the New Development Bank. Yeah, you need to tell me the amount of these projects, total amount of these projects. Some of you are saying 4, some of you are saying 3. The correct answer is option 4, that is $800 million. The worth of these projects are $800 million, and these projects has been launched by the New Development Bank. Next is, recently the World Bank has released its Doing Business report. This is a very important report. Ease of Doing Business report, you must have heard about it. This is so much in news, and World Bank released this particular report. So which of the following are the key indicators of this index? You need to tell me the key indicators of the Doing Business report of 2020. This is one of the most important report. Generally, a lot of questions are asked from this particular report. Yes, Sangeeta, you are correct. Correct answer is option 5, that is all of the above. All of the options given here are the key indicators of the Ease of Doing Business report. So there are actually 10 indicators on which countries are ranked on the basis of these indicators. So these are resolving insolvency, construction permits, trading across borders, registering property, paying taxes, getting electricity, starting a business, getting credit, protecting minority investors, and enforcing contract. So you need to also remember the rank of the India in this particular index. So these things are important for your examination point of view. Next is, which of the following nations has recently won the vote to host the Interpol General Assembly in the year 2022? So in 2022, Interpol General Assembly is going to take place at which of the following nation? This is the question. Tell me the name of the country where Interpol General Assembly is going to be held in year 2022. Yes, India. So in India, this Interpol meeting is going to be held in 2022. Next is, which of the following became the first UN organization to start accepting cryptocurrency donation? So this has become the first UN organization that will accept the donations in cryptocurrencies also. So which is that UN organization? Is it UNICEF, or is it ILO, or is it WTO? Tell me the answer here. This is a very important question. This can be asked in the exam actually. Correct answer is UNICEF here. So UNICEF has become the first UN organization to start accepting cryptocurrency donations. Next is, recently central government has launched which of the following schemes under which pregnant women or mothers up to 6 months after delivery and all new sick borns will be able to avail free healthcare benefits? So what is the name of that scheme in which pregnant women will get the benefit or free healthcare benefits or new sick newborns also? Guys, this is very important question. Actually, all the questions related to schemes are important for you, as well as reports related questions also, because these are generally asked in the NABARD exam if we see the past year papers. Yes, the correct answer is option 4, that is SUMAN. So SUMAN stands for Surakshit Matritva Ashwasan scheme. That can also be asked in the exam. Next is, recently Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship has signed a contract with which of the following institutions for introducing a 2-year Mahatma Gandhi National Fellowship Program? So Ministry of Skill Development has signed a contract with which institution for MGNF Fellowship Program? Correct answer is option 2, that is IIM Bangalore. So with IIM Bangalore, Ministry of Skill Development has signed a contract, and this IIM Bangalore will introduce a 2-year MGNF fellowship program. Yes, most of you have answered it correctly. Next is, which of the following ministries has recently launched an automated real-time performance smart board, which will act as a single window access for center, state or district specific projects? So which of the following ministry has launched this smart board, real-time performance smart board? Yeah, you have to tell me the name of the ministry which have launched this real-time performance smart board. So the name of the ministry is option 1, that is Ministry of IT. So obviously it is a smart board, it is related to IT sector. So obviously Ministry of Information Technology has launched this particular board. So guys, these were all the October current affairs for you, all the important October current affairs. Now we'll take break of few seconds so you guys can have water or take a short break. No, Ministry of Corporate is not the correct answer. Ministry of IT has launched this smart board. We'll start with the ESI current affairs of November in few seconds. Guys, is this session helping you? Today we are covering 3 months, September, October and November, and tomorrow we'll cover remaining two, that is January and December. We are going to cover more MCQs for the month of November, as the question of last 3 months are more important for you. So they are going to be around 60 questions from November month. And more MCQs tomorrow for December and January. Okay, let's start with the month of November now. Okay. So first question is, which one of the following state governments has recently signed agreements with Tata Strive and Tech Mahindra to add new dimensions in skilling and employability of the youth in state? So which of the following state government has signed this particular agreement? Tell me the name of the state, guys. So it is Odisha, which have signed agreement with Tata Strive and Tech Mahindra, so they can start or they can add new dimensions in skilling and employability of the youth. Yes, yes, Odisha is the correct answer here. Next is, recently the 8th Indo-German Energy Forum was concluded at which of the following places? So again, venue is asked in this question. Generally, in event type of questions, venue is asked. So you need to remember that whenever you read about news or any current affairs related to events. The correct answer is option A, that is New Delhi. Next is, which of the following Indian cities has recently been named as world's most polluted city, entering in Guinness World Record? So this city has made the Guinness World Record of the world's most polluted city. This can only happen only in India. So what is the name of that city? Yes, Kanpur has made the Guinness World Record for being the world's most polluted city. Next is, which of the following countries have recently signed the International Solar Alliance Framework Agreement? So recently, which country has joined the ISA Framework Agreement or signed the ISA Framework Agreement? Tell me the name of the country. Correct answer is option 4, that is both 1 and 2. So Eritrea as well as Saint Kitts and Nevis, these two countries have signed ISA Framework Agreement recently. So guys, whenever there is any country in news, you need to remember the currency of that country as well as the capital of that country. Next is, recently the Department of Land Resources, in collaboration with National Remote Sensing Center, Department of Space, has published the edition Wastelands Atlas of India. So, which edition of Wastelands Atlas of India has been released? You have to tell that. Yes, Eritrea and Saint Kitts is the correct answer. Now move on to this question. Which edition of Wastelands Atlas of India has been recently released? Which have been released by the Department of Land Resources in collaboration with National Remote Sensing Center. That can also be asked in the exam. Correct answer is option 2, that is 5th. Yes. Next is the Rising Himachal Global Investors Meet 2019. So it was held at which of the following cities? Again, venues asked here. Correct answer is option 3, that is Dharamshala. So the Rising Himachal Global Investors Meet was held in Dharamshala. Next is International Conference on Soil and Water Resource Management for Climate Smart Agriculture and Global Food and Livelihood Security. So this particular conference was organized at which of the following places? Magazine related question I will answer in the end of the session. So you can ask there. Where this particular conference was organized? So it was organized at New Delhi. Guys, most of the international conferences are held in New Delhi, that you can remember. Next is, recently the curtain raiser event of the 5th Global Exhibition on Services was held at which of the following places? So you don't have to be confused, because here the venue of Global Exhibition on Services is not asked. Here the curtain raiser event, where it was held, that is asked in the question. So curtain raiser event of 5th Global Exhibition on Services was held at New Delhi. Actually, this is a trivial question. Actually, 5th Global Exhibition on Services was held in New Delhi, that you need to. Curtain raiser event was held in New Delhi, and this exhibition is going to be held in Bengaluru, and Uttar Pradesh is the partner state. So you need to remember the venue of this exhibition, which is Bengaluru, as well as partner state, which is Uttar Pradesh. Next is, as per economic outlook for Southeast Asia, China and India 2020, responding to environmental hazards in city. So according to this, what will be the India's GDP growth in the period 2020 to 2024? Correct answer is option 4, that is 6.6. So according to this particular outlook, India's GDP growth in the period 2020 to 2024 is going to be 6.6%. Yes, yes, most of you have answered it correct. Next is, which of the following countries has recently pledged to invest 1 billion over the next 5 years on environmentally friendly urban mobility in India? So which country is going to invest 1 billion euros on environmental friendly urban mobility in India? Actually, you can take the hint from Euro. Yes, correct answer is option 3, that is Germany. So recently German Chancellor Angela Merkel visited India, and there she pledged to invest 1 billion euros over the next 5 years. Next is, recently the Empowered Committee under Nirbhaya framework has approved proposal to develop which of the following systems aiming at better addressing of safety issues of women and children. So under Nirbhaya framework, some few systems have been developed. So what are those systems which are there to address the safety issues of women and children? Correct answer is option 4th, that is both 1 and 2. So anti-human trafficking units and women help desk. These two systems have been developed under the Nirbhaya framework. You need to remember these. Next is, according to IMF forecast, which nation is about to experience the fastest economic growth in the world? So according to IMF, which nation is going to experience fastest economic growth? Yeah, tell me the name of the country which is going to experience fastest economic growth according to IMF forecast. Correct answer is option 3, that is Guyana. So Guyana is going to experience fastest economic growth in the country because recently oil wells or oil reserve have been found in the country. So it is going to see its economic balloon by 86% next year. Next is, recently with which international organizations the Tamil Nadu government has signed $451 million loan to strengthen the power connectivity of Chennai-Kanyakumari industrial corridor? So which body has given $451 million loan to Tamil Nadu for Chennai-Kanyakumari industrial corridor? What is the name of that body? Yeah, tell me the name of the body which are going to give $451 million to Tamil Nadu. Correct answer is option 1, that is Asian Development Bank. So the total cost of the project is $653 million, out of which $451 million will be provided by Asian Development Bank. Next is, recently India has decided to withdraw which of these trade agreements, as India did not receive any credible assurance on market access and non-tariff barriers. So India is going to withdraw from which of these trade agreements? This is a very important question. Actually, it was so much in news. So you must know this. This is an easy question if you have read current affairs properly. Correct answer is option 3, that is RCEP. So India has withdrawn from RCEP. So the proposed agreement was actually unacceptable to India in its current form, and that's why India has withdrawn from this trade pact. So RCEP stands for Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. Next is, recently which of the following states has banned 15 years old government cars? So recently a state government has banned that the cars which are older than 15 years, they won't be allowed. So what is the name of that state? This measure has been taken to control the pollution, to reduce the emissions from the vehicles, because old vehicles, yes, the correct answer is 4th, that is Bihar. So Bihar has banned 15 years old government cars, and also all commercial vehicles of the same age will be stopped from plying in Patna and adjacent regions. Next is, which of one of the following villages has acquired a badge of honor of first eco village of Odisha? So which village has become the first eco village of Odisha? Tell me the name of the village which has become the first eco village. Correct correct answer is option 3, that is Muduli Gadia is the name of the village which has become the first eco village of Odisha. So Muduli Gadia is a village in Odisha's Nayagarh district. So you also need to remember the name of the district in which this village lies. So it is in Nayagarh district. Next is, recently the Confederation of All India Traders has launched a nationwide movement to protest against which of these e-commerce companies. So recently CAIT, they have launched a nationwide movement to protest against the company. What is the name of the company? Or companies? Yes, Sangeeta, it is near Mahanadi River. The name of the company are Amazon and Flipkart. So CAIT launched a nationwide movement against Amazon and Flipkart to protest. Next is, according to the data released by the Center for Monitoring Indian Economy, the unemployment rate in India reached to a 3-year high of how much percent? So according to this body, unemployment rate in India reached to a 3-year high of how much percent? You need to tell me the percentage amount by which unemployment rate in India increased. According to the data by the Center for Monitoring Indian Economy, correct answer is option 3, that is by 8.5%. Unemployment rate reached 8.5% according to the data released by this particular body. Vaibhav, is there any problem in voice? Tell me if there is any problem in voice. Next is, which one of the following ministries has recently allocated a separate HS code for the khadi fabric? So recently a separate HS code for the khadi fabric has been released. So it has been released by which of the following ministries? Am I audible to you guys? Please type yes if I'm audible to you. Okay, no problem. Correct answer is option 5, that is Ministry of Commerce and Industry has released a particular separate code for the khadi fabric. So earlier there was only one code for all the textiles. Now a separate code has been released for the khadi fabric. HS stands for harmonized system actually. Next is, which of the following persons has co-chaired the 19th India-Russia Intergovernmental Commission on Military and Military Technical Cooperation meeting in Moscow, Russia? So which particular person co-chaired this particular meeting which was held in Moscow in Russia? Tell me the name of the person. Correct answer is Rajnath Singh, who is our defense minister. So he co-chaired the 19th India-Russia Intergovernmental Commission on Military and Military Technical Cooperation. And this particular meeting was held in Moscow in Russia. Next is, recently the first ever BIMSTEC Ports Conclave has been held at which of the following place? So this particular conclave was held at which place? You need to tell me the name of the place where this BIMSTEC Ports Conclave, and it was actually the first ever conclave, that's why it is more important for you. Correct answer is option 3, that is Vishakhapatnam, which is also called as Vizag. So at Vizag, this first ever BIMSTEC Ports Conclave was held. Next is, recently RBS India has announced the winners of 9th edition of the RBS Earth Heroes Awards. Which of the following is the theme of these awards? So RBS Earth Heroes Awards were given. What is the theme of these awards? Tell me guys fast, what is the theme of this particular award? Themes are very important. The theme of this is option 4, that is climate change. So climate change was the theme of RBS Earth Heroes Awards. So those are the heroes of the earth who are stopping the climate change. In this way you can remember this. Next is, recently school education department of which of the following states has decided to convert all government MPP and Zilla Parishad schools and all classes into English medium. So, which state school education department has decided to convert all the schools in English medium? Tell me the name of the state. Correct answer is option 5, that is Andhra Pradesh. So, Andhra Pradesh state government has decided to convert all those government and Jila Parishad schools into English medium schools. Next is, which of the following higher education institution has recently launched India's first indigenously designed standing wheelchair? So, the name of this standing wheelchair is Arise. That can also be asked in the exam. And it is actually first indigenously designed standing wheelchair. So, which of the higher education institution has launched this Arise standing wheelchair? Correct answer is option first, that is IIT Madras. So, IIT Madras has launched this standing wheelchair and the name of the wheelchair is Arise. Next is, 6th Parliamentary Speaker Summit was organized in which of the following countries? So, recently a Parliamentary Speaker Summit was held. So, it was held in which of the following countries? You have to tell me the name of the country. Is it India or is it China or is it Germany? Tell me the name of the country here. Correct answer is option 3, that is Japan. So this Parliamentary Speaker Summit was organized at Japan. Next is, recently which of the following organizations has released the study called Trade and Trade Diversion Effects of US Tariffs on China, as per which India has gained $755 million. So which of the organization has released that study, Trade and Trade Diversion Effects of US Tariffs on China? Tell me the name of the organization here. Come on guys, lot of you are saying option 3, is it UNCTAD? Yes, correct answer is option 3, United Nations Conference on Trade and Development has released this particular study, and according to this study, India has gained $755 million in additional exports to US due to US-China war. So actually, India is benefiting from this US-China trade war. And India has gained $755 million. Next is, recently global ratings agency Moody's has changed its outlook from India's credit ratings to what? So earlier it was stable. Now it has changed to what? India's credit ratings according to Moody's. This is also a very important question. Moody's has changed its outlook to what? Earlier it was stable. Now it has become negative. So you need to remember, earlier it was stable. Now it has changed from stable to negative according to Moody's. Next is, recently Vice President of India, that is M. Venkaiya Naidu. So he inaugurated the 10th Asian Conference of Emergency Medicine in New Delhi. So this particular conference was held in New Delhi. Who among the following have organized this event? So here the organizer of event is asked. This conference was held in New Delhi. Who organized this? Correct answer is option 5th, that is both 1 and 2. So, Asian Society for Emergency Medicine as well as Society for Emergency Medicine India. These two jointly organized this particular conference. Next is, which of these states has highest number of farmer suicides as per the accidental and suicidal deaths in India report? So recently, accidental and suicidal deaths in India report was released. According to which state has highest number of farmer suicides? Actually, this is very much in news, so you must know this. Correct answer is option 3, that is Maharashtra. So Maharashtra continues to account for the highest number of farmer suicides in the country, with 3,661 suicides in year 2016. Next is, which of the following states accounted for the highest number of suicides by daily wage earners according to this report? So earlier it was asked highest number of suicides for farmers. Now it is asked that in which state highest number of suicides by daily wage earners? Hello Himanshu. Correct answer is option second, that is Tamil Nadu. So for farmers it is Maharashtra and for daily wage earners it is Tamil Nadu. Next is 19th IORA Council of Ministers meeting was held at which of the following places? So again venues asked here, where this particular 19th IORA Council of Ministers meeting was held. Tell me the name of the place. Yes, Tamil Nadu is correct answer here. Now tell me the IORA Council of Ministers meeting venue. So it was held at option 4, that is Abu Dhabi. So at Abu Dhabi this particular ministers meeting was held. And the theme of the meeting was promoting a shared destiny and path to prosperity in the Indian Ocean. So venue is important as well as theme is also important because that is also asked in the exam generally. Next question is, recently the cabinet has approved special window to provide funding to housing projects that are stuck with the aim of reviving the key sector, providing a boost to the economy and bringing relief to home buyers. So how much amount of special window has been approved by cabinet to provide funding to housing projects that are stuck? Tell me the amount that cabinet has approved, that is a special window to provide funding to housing projects. Most of you are answering option 3, that is correct, that is rupees 25,000 crore is the window to provide funding to housing projects. Next is, recently which of the following has inaugurated an exhibition called Meet at Agra? So which of the following body inaugurated this particular meeting which was held at Agra Trade Center in Uttar Pradesh? Yes, tell me the name of the ministry which inaugurated this particular exhibition. Correct answer is option 5, that is Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship inaugurated this particular exhibition. And this exhibition was held at Agra Trade Center in Uttar Pradesh. Next is, Ministry of Steel has issued the steel scrap recycling policy to promote 6 hours as one of the objective. So which of the following is not included in 6 hours mentioned? So recently steel scrap recycling policy was released to promote 6 hours. So to answer this question you need to know what are those 6 hours in the steel scrap recycling policy. Which of the following is not included in that 6 hours? Correct answer is option 3, that is repair. So what are those 6 hours? So these are reduce, reuse, recycle, recover, redesign and remanufacture. And repair is not part of it. So that is the answer here. Next is, recently which of the following government bodies has got environmental clearance for its proposed 100 KLPD lignocellulosic 2G ethanol plant at Bahuli? So which body is going to establish this 2G ethanol plant at Bahuli in Panipat? So when you have already know that this lignocellulosic 2G ethanol plant is in Bahuli in Panipat. So which of the body has got environmental clearance to set up this? Correct answer is option 3, that is Indian Oil Corporation Limited. And the estimated investment of this plant is rupees 766 crore. Next is, the 39th India International Trade Fair was inaugurated at Pragati Maidan in New Delhi. So what is the theme of this fair? It is India International Trade Fair. What? Tell me the theme of the fair, guys. It was held at Pragati Maidan in New Delhi. The theme of the fair is ease of doing business. So you can remember this, that this was international trade fair. So trade is relating to ease of doing business. India is taking so much initiatives to improve the ranking in ease of doing business. Theme of the fair was ease of doing business. Option 3. Next question is, under Nishtha program, the teachers will develop their skills on which of the following aspects? So recently a program has been launched called as Nishtha. So teachers will develop their skills under this program on which of the following aspects? Actually, the parameters are asked in this question. What are the parameters on the basis of which teachers will develop their skills under Nishtha program? Correct answer is option 5, that is all of the above. So these are the parameters or the aspects on which teachers will develop their skills under Nishtha program. So Nishtha stands for National Initiative for School Health and Teachers Holistic Advancement. You need to remember this full form also, that can also be asked in the exam. And the teachers will develop their skills on various aspects, which are learning outcomes, school safety and security, ICT in teaching and learning, environmental concerns and school-based assessment. Next is, recently the 11th BRICS Summit was hosted in Brasilia, Brazil. Which of the following was theme for the summit? So one information is given in the question itself, that 11th BRICS Summit was held in Brazil. Now tell me the theme of this summit. This is very important question. Venue is already given in the question. Now tell me the theme of this summit. Lot of you are saying option 3, some are saying 4 and 5 also. Okay, correct answer is option 3, that is economic growth for an innovative future. Next is, which of the following statements is or are correct regarding the Swachh Nirmal Tat Abhiyan? So recently Swachh Nirmal Tat Abhiyan was organized. Which of the following statements are correct regarding it? You have to read it very carefully. Tell me the correct statement here regarding the Swachh Nirmal Tat Abhiyan. So Tat stands for beaches. So it was for the cleanliness of beaches actually. Tell me the correct statement here. Correct is option 4th, that is the identified beaches are in 10 coastal states or union territories. All the statements given here apart from this are incorrect. So let us know about it. So under the drive 50 beaches have been identified, but in question actually 20 was mentioned, that's why it was incorrect. And at the end of the drive, the best 3 beaches will awarded, and this campaign was to clean beaches and to create awareness among the citizens. And 10 identified beaches are in the 10 states. And what are those 10 states or UTs? It is Gujarat, Daman and Diu, Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Puducherry, Andhra Pradesh and Odisha. So in these 10 coastal states, beaches were identified. Actually 50 beaches were identified, and at the end of the drive, 3 beaches were awarded. Next is, who among the following has recently selected to chair the committee drafted on new national water policy? So who will head the committee which have been formed to draft new national water policy? You need to tell me the name of the person who is the head of the committee which is going to draft new national water policy. Correct answer is option 1st, that is Mihir Shah. So Mihir Shah will head the committee which is going to draft new national water policy. Next is, government has recently approved setting up 4 medical device park. The park will be set up in which of the following state? So recently government has announced that 4 medical device park will be established under Make in India initiative. So where these parks are going to be established, in which state? It can be more than one state also. So tell me the correct answer here. Where these parks are going to be established? Correct answer is option 5, that is all of the above. So in these 4 states, you need to remember that these 4 states, in Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu and Kerala. So all the southern states, in these 4 states, the park will be set up. 4 medical device park. Next is, recently the Jammu and Kashmir government has set up a 10-member committee to declare which one of the following famous places as an eco-sensitive zone. So recently Jammu and Kashmir government has announced that it is going to declare one famous place as eco-sensitive zone. So what is that place? इज इट बालताल और इज इट खिलान मार्ग वैली और इज इट निगान लेक और इज इट डल लेक. टेल मी द नेम ऑफ द प्लेस विच इज गोइंग टू बी डिक्लेयर्ड एज इको सेंसिटिव जोन. सो येस करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन फोर, दैट इज डल लेक इज गोइंग टू बी डिक्लेयर्ड एज इको सेंसिटिव जोन बिकॉज इट्स एरिया इट्स कैपेसिटी हैज बीन श्रंक टू अबाउट 40% एंड इट्स क्वालिटी हैज ऑल्सो डिटीरियोरेटेड. दैट्स वाई जम्मू एंड कश्मीर हैज डिक्लेयर्ड दैट डल लेक इज एन इको सेंसिटिव जोन एंड नाउ लॉट ऑफ एफर्ट्स एंड इनिशिएटिव्स विल बी टेकन टू इम्प्रूव द कंडीशन ऑफ दिस लेक. Next is the 18th Council of Heads of Government of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization was held in which of the following places? So this particular Council of Heads of Government meeting or council was held. It was held at which of the following places? We'll cover 60 questions from the month of November and we are on 43. Tell me the correct answer here guys. 18th Council of Heads of Government of SCO was held in which of the following places? Correct answer is option first, that is Tashkent in Uzbekistan. Next is recently a president rule has been imposed in Maharashtra. So the Union Cabinet recommended president's rules on the suggestion of Maharashtra governor. So in this question, name of the Maharashtra governor is asked. What is the name of the Maharashtra governor who suggested president's rule in the state? But now recently a new government has been formed, but before that president rule was imposed in the Maharashtra. What is the name of the governor of Maharashtra? Correct answer is option fifth, that is Bhagat Singh Koshyari, and the new chief minister is Uddhav Thackeray. Governor is Bhagat Singh Koshyari. Next is, recently the United Nations Children Fund, that is UNICEF. So UNICEF has released a report on pneumonia. Which of the following is India's rank in number of pneumonia death of children under age 5? So generally, children are affected by pneumonia, especially under the age of 5. So what is the India's rank in number of pneumonia death of children? According to UNICEF, what is the rank of India in the number of pneumonia death of children? Correct answer is option third, that is India is at the second place in the number of pneumonia deaths. So India need to improve a lot, in especially in the sector, in the health sector. Next is, recently in November, which of the following investment bank has announced that it will stop funding fossil fuel projects and the add on of 2021? So which investment bank is going to stop funding fossil fuel projects by the end of 2021? So it is actually an initiative to reduce pollution, to reduce emissions. Which institute has taken this initiative? Correct answer is option first, that is European Investment Bank has announced that it is going to stop funding fossil fuel projects at the end of 2021. So correct answer is EIB. Next is, which of these organizations has recently partnered with Ayushman Bharat to provide medical care to its beneficiaries in 102 designated newly implemented district? So which organization is going to provide medical care to its beneficiaries under Ayushman Bharat? Tell me the name of the organization which will provide medical care to its beneficiaries. Correct answer is option third, that is ESIC is going to provide medical care for the beneficiaries of Ayushman Bharat. Next is, recently India in partnership with the UNDP got $43 million from UNFCCC to boost climate resilience in which of the following coastal state? So India has got $43 million to boost climate resilience in which of the state? Tell me the correct answer here. What is the name of the state which have got $43 million to boost climate resilience? Correct answer is option 4, that is all of the above. So Maharashtra, Odisha and Andhra Pradesh. These three states have got $43 million so that climate resilience can be improved. And this project is funded by the Green Climate Fund. That is also a very important fact. Next is, recently which of these UTs or states has launched Mukhya Mantri Septic Tank Safai Yojana, a scheme to enable citizens to get their septic tanks cleaned for free? So which state government has launched this particular scheme? And under this scheme, septic tanks will be cleaned for free. What is the name of the state which have launched Mukhya Mantri Septic Tank Safai Yojana? Yes, correct answer is option first, that is Delhi NCR. Next is, which of the following anti-bribery standard setting organizations has released the bribery risk matrix? So which organization has released the bribery risk matrix 2019? Tell me the correct answer here. Correct answer is option second, that is Trace International. So Trace International has released the bribery risk matrix. Next is, in the bribery risk matrix 2019, the score has been allotted on the basis of which of these factors? So again, parameters are asked here. Generally, in report or indices kind of question, parameters are asked or rank is asked. So on the basis of which factors the score has been allotted? What is the correct answer? Yes, Trace International is correct. Now move on to the factors. Correct answer is option fifth, that is all of the above. So on the basis of these parameters, the score has been allotted under the bribery risk matrix. So there are four factors on which the score was based. What are those four factors? Business interactions with government, anti-bribery deterrence and enforcement, government and civil service transparency, and capacity for civil society oversight. Next question is, which of the following nations has been ranked first as the country with lowest bribery risk in the bribery risk matrix? So which country has the lowest risk of bribery? What is the name of that country? Come on, tell me. It cannot be an underdeveloped country, that I must tell you, because in underdeveloped countries, bribery risk is high. Can you tell me the name of the country which has the lowest bribery risk? Correct answer is option fourth, that is New Zealand. So New Zealand is the one which have been ranked as the first country with lowest bribery risk, and Somalia is at the last rank, which has the highest risk of bribe demands nation. And among the South Asian countries, Bangladesh is at the first position. Next is, as per annual bribery risk matrix, India has been ranked at which position? So its score is 48. Tell me the rank of India. So the rank of India is 78th in the bribery risk matrix with the score of 48. Next is, recently which of the following international organizations has given India a $500 million loan to develop suburban railway network in Mumbai? So which of the organization has contributed to develop suburban rail network in Mumbai? Tell me the name of the organization. The amount of the loan is $500 million. Who have provided $500 million to India? Come on. For suburban railway network. Correct answer is option second, that is AIIB, which is Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. Next is, which of the following agencies has recently set up an online child sexual abuse and exploitation prevention unit to counter the growing menace of child porn on the internet? So which agency have set up an unit to counter the menace of child porn on the internet? Tell me the name of the agency or the body which have launched this particular unit. Correct answer is option third, that is Central Bureau of Investigation, that is CBI, has launched this unit to counter the growing menace of child porn on the internet. Next is, who among the following international research collaboration has published the Brown to Green report? So recently, Brown to Green report was released in the year 2019. Which of the following international research collaboration has published that report? brown to green report. You must know that who have published this particular report. So brown to green report has been published by the Climate Transparency. So India is the only country among G20 nations that is close to 1.5 degree Celsius temperature rise pathway according to this particular report. This is the most important finding of this particular report. Next is, recently which of these nations has released that $28 million to Nepal as third tranche of financial aid to provide help to people in Nuwakot and Gorkha districts so that they can rebuild their houses. So which country has given the $28 million grant to Nepal to help the people in Nuwakot and Gorkha because they were devastated by earthquake in 2015? Correct answer is option third, that is India. So India has provided $28 million to Nepal as financial aid so that people of Nuwakot and Gorkha district can rebuild their homes which are devastated because of earthquake. And India committed $100 million as a grant for supporting these houses in addition to $50 million from line of credit. So India is going to provide this much of money. In third tranche, India has released $28 million. Next is, recently the second edition of Paris Peace Forum held in Paris, France. It put specific focus on governance solutions in six major themes. So which one of the following themes is not included? So Paris Peace Forum was held in Paris and it focused on six major themes. So which of the following is not the theme of the solutions? You have to identify that which of the following is not the theme under the Paris Peace Forum. Correct answer is option fourth, that is defense. Yes guys, you can even conclude from it that it was related to peace. So it was peace forum, so defense cannot be the theme of the discussion. So what are the themes? There were six major themes: peace and security, development, environment, new technologies, inclusive economy, and culture and education. Next is, recently the fourth UNESCO General Conference was held at which of the following places? 40th UNESCO General Conference. What is the venue of this particular conference? What is the venue of 40th UNESCO General Conference? Correct answer is option fifth, that is France. Next is, which one of the following ministries has launched the Skills Build platform? Guys, this is the last question for today's session. Come on, answer me fast. Which one of the following ministries has launched the Skill Build platform? This is an easy question actually. You can easily answer this. Skills Build platform has launched by which ministry? I need to see that how many people can answer this correctly. Correct answer is option fourth, that is yes, Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. So guys, these were the questions for the month of November here. And here we have completed all the questions for today's session. And as you all know that there is a 50% discount going on NABARD courses. Code is NABARD50. You can apply this code and avail the discount of 50%. And if you guys have any doubt, then you can answer. Then you can ask. I can answer those. Thank you so much, you guys. You were all very enthusiastic and giving correct answers continuously. Tomorrow we are going to discuss ESI current affairs of January and December. If you guys have any doubt, you can ask me. Then I'll wind up the session. Cosmic power, if you are weak in English, then practice is the only solution. Please practice more and more mocks. thank you, Arpit, that our session are helpful for your preparation. That is our aim. To help you guys as much as we can. We are not sure about the static part actually. We'll discuss all the current part and reports and schemes and budget and economic survey and all, but we are not sure about the static part. ARD section will start after the ESI current affairs. That is from the day after tomorrow. Tomorrow we'll have one more session of ESI. Then we'll discuss two sessions of ARD. Okay, perfectly imperfect. I will check that. Can you tell me the question number? In which question it was? Option 4 was mentioned. Thank you, Cosmic Power. Yes, we'll cover budget and economic survey both. PDF is available on Telegram and the link is given in the description box. Explanation are also given along with questions in the PDF. So you can revise from there also. Compiled PDF of January is available in the course, Prashant. Okay, I'll check it. Okay. In November MCQs, I will check. Arpit, actually pattern keeps changing, so we cannot tell you exactly that how much percent static part is asked, but obviously current part is asked more generally. Tomorrow will be the remaining ESI current affairs of the December and January month. Dipanshu, you can start from September to be on safer side actually. From September to Feb, till 20th Feb actually. You have to give more focus to the last 3 months, but you should start reading from September. Yes, we'll provide budget and economic survey. Don't worry about that. Also, we'll take session on that. Okay then, thank you so much guys. It was a very nice session and you guys were very enthusiastic. You were continuously keep answering. So that was it for today's video. Tomorrow we'll take the remaining session. Okay, bye bye, take care. Happy learning. Now I'm stopping the session.